Hi, and welcome back to SpectraPure TV. Today I'll show you how to increase the capacity of your RO or RODI unit by installing a piggyback kit. If you find yourself in a situation where you could use more water than your current system is able to produce, there is no need to invest in a larger system or to run your current system 24 hours a day just to keep up with the demand. Low pressure could be affecting your production. If you have below 45 psi, then a booster pump is recommended here. Since not only will it increase production, you'll also get better rejection. However, if you have pressure above 45 psi and you just need more water, the solution may be simple. We'll add a second membrane. This can be done with any standard 90 gallon per day system, but we'll use the CSPDI here for reference. The piggyback kit contains all the necessary parts for a quick and simple install. The housing, the brackets, push fittings for the membrane housing, some extra quarter inch tubing, the T that combines the product water outputs, and the FR180 flow restrictor. What we're basically going to do is feed the second membrane with wastewater from the first and combine the product of both into one. So we'll still end up with one product and one waistline. Installation is simple. First and foremost, disconnect the yellow waistline of the existing membrane housing. Remove the flow restrictor because we won't need this anymore. We're going to be installing a higher volume flow restrictor on the waistline of the new membrane housing. Let's go ahead and install the elbow push connect fittings onto the new membrane housing, black grommet to input feed, product water to blue, and yellow to waste. And notice that the waste port is slightly offset and the product water port is more towards the center of the membrane housing. Install the double-sided clips onto the first membrane housing, like I did here, so you can attach the piggyback. Orient the piggyback housing to where the cap, which is the feed input, is on the same side as the waste port of the existing membrane housing. This just looks cleaner and uses less tubing for the connections. Connect a piece of black tubing from the waistline of the existing membrane over to the new membrane housing. Then, cut a piece of product water tube long enough to fit from the product water output port of the new membrane housing to the existing one. Then disconnect the product water tube and install the T. This will allow us to connect both product water outputs into one. We'll just use a short piece from this end back into the original membrane housing. If you didn't have a DI cartridge, then out of this T, this output would just go straight to your RO reservoir. But since this is a CSPDI system, this goes down to the DI cartridge. Most importantly, install the new flow restrictor into the waistline and reinstall that onto the drain of the new membrane housing. We'll go ahead and turn the system on and run it for an hour so that the new membrane can fully saturate. We'll check for leaks, secure any necessary connections. After about an hour or so, the membrane should be producing near rated capacity, and the product to waste ratio should be checked at this point. If the ratio is less than 4:1, then cut the flow restrictor following the guidelines in the manual, or see how it's done in our How to Set Your Flow Restrictor video. If you had a flush kit installed, that assembly is simply moved from the waste port of the first membrane to the waste port of the new membrane. And also be certain to check that you have close to 60 psi to begin with, since low pressure could really compromise the performance of two membranes in series. So in just a few minutes, you could increase your production without compromising space, and the best part is, it's also easy on the budget. Thanks for watching.